Hello students, welcome you all to my YouTube channel. And here I am going to start chapter 4 of computer, paragraph formatting in Word. Please listen to the explanation, read the chapter thoroughly, prepare inside questions and exercise questions, mark the lines, try to understand, read it thoroughly. Because understanding of the chapter is must. Before learning, you should know and understand. Page 35 of your book. Chapter 4. Paragraph formatting is an essential part of creating effective documents in Word. In Microsoft Word, we can format paragraph, make it very attractive, make it very colorful, and then we can put some alignments, indentation, line spacing so that it looks very attractive. So for this purpose, for giving some extra effects or special effects to make it look very attractive and catch the attention of the people, we can do this paragraph formatting. When a document is formatted properly, the text is spaced and positioned nicely. And in Word paragraph formatting, we get several features, like we can determine paragraph alignment, indentation, spacing, all these things. So we can apply and make it look very attractive and beautiful. Now in this quick tip, in Word, a new paragraph begins when we press the Enter key. In Microsoft Word document, if we want to start a new paragraph, then we have to press the Enter key. However, when we start a document, we can manage to make some changes to this default settings. If we want, we can change that default settings. And when we make this default settings, then those settings only get applied in the new document. That means in the present document in which you are working, in that particular document only that particular changes will be applied. If you put any change, if you make any change from the default. Okay, now let us turn to the next page, page 36 of your book. Displaying ruler. Now, rulers in Word do more than measures. In maths, we use ruler. For drawing purpose, we use ruler. That is a different thing. But here in computer, ruler in Microsoft Word means more than taking measurement. Horizontal ruler and vertical ruler. Horizontal ruler above the document shows the length of the typing line. And the vertical ruler along the left edge, left side of the document, helps you to adjust the top and bottom margins and then change the table row and heights. Figure 4.1, it displays the rulers. Click the View tab. Under View, you see this is the View tab. Under View, you have the Select or Clear the Ruler checkbox. Here if you click on this checkbox, then you will be able to view it. Next is aligning text. Aligning or alignment is the arrangement of text in the margin. That means from both the margins, left and right, if the text is properly placed and a particular distance is mentioned, so the way of arranging the text within the margin is called alignment. In Microsoft Word, you will find actually four types. But before that, I want to tell you, there are actually two types of alignment, that is horizontal and vertical. Horizontal means in this way, and vertical means in this way, column wise vertical. And in this way, it shows horizontal. So these two types of alignment we can do. And in the horizontal alignment, there are four types. four types of horizontal alignments: align left, align center, align right, and justify. And these are the symbols. In the ribbons, you will find this type of symbols. Center, they will show this kind of lines. Align right, towards the right, the lines will be drawn. Justified, you see all the lines are of equal size, equal length. Left, it will be aligned to the left. So these are the buttons, the symbols by which you can identify that which button is used for what alignment. And the shortcut keys are also given. Control plus S, that means Control plus L. We have to press Control and L together to bring this change. First, we have to select the paragraph or the line in which we want to make this change. And after selecting it, then we have to press both the keys together from the keyboard to make this change. Control plus E for center alignment, Control plus R for right alignment, and Control plus J for justify alignment. Control plus L left alignment means it will take the text towards the left margin. Centers mean it will bring it exactly in between the page, the document. Lines up text flush on both the left and right margin, leaving a red left edge towards the left. Towards the right it will take when you click on right alignment, and lot of space will be there in the right side. In the left side there will be lot of space and the lines will be taken to the side of the right. Justify means it will, all the lines will come in this way. All the lines will end, the edges will be same. Okay, now let us see the steps. The steps to change the horizontal alignment: select the paragraph you want to align. See, in this figure, number one, they have selected it, therefore one color background is shown. This means with the help of the mouse, they have dragged and selected it. Then click the appropriate button alignment, whichever you want from this home tab. There you will get various options. Whichever you choose, it will be applied in that way. Then indentation. Indentation is the distance of the paragraph from either left or right margin. Like, see, this is the document. This is the left margin and this side another right margin is there. So, indentation is the distance of this paragraph. See, from this left margin, the writing starts here and the margin is this one. So, there is a gap, there is space. Similarly, this side also, from the right margin, there is some space between the paragraph and the right margin. So, this is called indentation. The distance of the paragraph from either the left or the right. Left indentation, it is the distance of the paragraph from the left margin. Right means it is the distance of the paragraph from the right margin. And the special two types of indents are there. The first line, that means it makes the first line of paragraph indented more towards the right. Only the first line, it will be indented. That means it will go to the side of the right side. Only the first line. If we click on this first line option, if we choose this first line indentation, these are special indentation. And if we choose the first line indentation, then only the first line will move towards the right. But the rest lines will remain the same. Only the first line will move towards the right. Hanging, the first line will move more towards the left compared to the subsequent lines, means the lines that come after that. The first line in in hanging alignment, the first line will go to the side of the left, but the following lines, the lines that are coming after it, will remain same. Then paragraph indent markers are shown on the horizontal ruler. This is the horizontal ruler and the indent markers are there. At the left of the horizontal ruler, you will see the following marks, this kind of marks. This is for right indent. This is for left indent. These marks you will see. These markers you can move and drag and then change the setting. Next page. Follow the steps, page 38. Follow the steps to set the indentation from the text.
select the text first. Selection is must, children, because without selection you cannot make any changes. So selection is must. First you have to select by moving the mouse on that. Then click on the layout tab. Under ribbon you will get this layout tab. Then you specify the value. Value means from what point you want to start. Then you give the settings, left and right indent under the paragraph group, and then you set it. Adding paragraph borders. Now what are borders? You know, in your copies, in your exercise books, there are some margins, borders drawn from two sides. In computer you can get it in on all four sides, or any one side, or any of your choice you can put the borders. Now adding borders and adding some shade to paragraphs actually make it look very attractive and organized, so that it becomes easier for the readers to read it. So therefore borders are lines that you can add to the top, bottom, left or right of paragraph. See, under home tab you will get this options. This icon is used for shading. In ribbon on top, this everything will be shown in ribbon. This one is for shading and this box is for border. If you click, first you have to select that paragraph, select it and then click. Then the different borders options will come. Whichever you choose, you can choose and apply it. See, these are the border names, bottom border, top border. See, when it is clicked, just beside this image there is more black drop down arrow. When you click on this arrow, this list will open up, and when this list will open you will be able to see this various types of borders. Any one border of your choice, of your as per your requirement, you can put that one in the document. But remember, children, before putting the document you have to first select the paragraph or the line or the page in which you want to put the border. Because without selection, no work or no extra special feature or formatting can be done. Because when you select the portion or the paragraph or the line, only after that, that special effect will be applied on that one. So selection is a must in Microsoft Word document to make these changes. Then there are the steps which you can read of your own. Place the insertion point in the paragraph in which you want to put the border. Insertion means the point where you want to start and insert. If you bring the cursor over there, the cursor will start blinking. So then you can understand that from that point you want to make the change, from there you want to insert something. So that is the insertion point. So you have to bring the cursor over there and then select the border. Click on this drop down arrow will open. Click on this drop down arrow, this list will open up, then you select any borders and then that particular border will be applied. Then let us move to page 39 and paragraph shading. Now for some extra background color, again you have to place the insertion point in the paragraph. That means at what point you want to insert, you have to take the cursor with the help of the mouse in that particular place. And then select it by dragging. See, this yellow background has come. Generally, a sky color background highlight comes here, which shows that it is selected. And after that, again you go to home tab. This is home tab. Just beside file, you have the home tab. Under home tab on the ribbon, this area is called the ribbon. Here, under home tab, you click here. They will show different colors. And with this color you can apply the shading. Just click here, any color you choose from this one, and then apply it. So these are the steps. This is how you have to do it. Next is line spacing. Line spacing is the amount of space between the lines of paragraph. See here, three lines are written in this yellow color background. Three lines are written. Now in between these two lines, if I want to extend the space, increase the space or decrease it or adjust, make any adjustment, increasing, decreasing or making such adjustment between the space of these two lines or three lines or four lines, whatever is written over there, this is meant by adding some line spacing. Now how we can do? So line spacing is therefore is the amount of space between the lines of paragraph. How we can do, you see? Line spacing can be specified in lines or units called points. This kind of points will come, you see, where it points the arrow 1.0, 1.15, 1.5, 2.0, 2.5, 3.0. So these are the points, okay. And under again home tab, you have to click on this. There is a small drop down arrow, click here. If you click there, then this menu will open up. And from there you choose any line spacing which you want to put. If you choose 3.0 line spacing, then there will be more space between the two lines. If you choose 1 or 1.15, then the space between the two lines will be reduced. So under the home tab, you have to click the line and paragraph spacing command. Drop down menu or list will come. Drop down means the list that opens down, that is called drop down. And this is the drop down arrow, the small black color arrow that you find is the drop down arrow. So it will show you the list, the numbers, according to which you can change the line spacing, and if you apply it, the lines will be changed. This is how you have to do. Next, come to page 40. On top you have a quick tip that is very, very important, children. On top of page 40, the default spacing. Default, I told you, something which is set from beforehand in your computer. So what is the default line? 1.08. By default it is there. But we can change it. Single line spacing means single space will be there. If we increase the line spacing to 1.5, it will be slightly increased. If we choose double, then it will be doubled. So these are the various line spacing options that come. Single, 1.5, double, at least, exactly. You can give a reading to it. I'm not going in detail, but these options will be opened up when you choose the line spacing options. And from there you can choose any one you like. Then again there is a quick tip on page 40. Very important. It shows the shortcut keys for the different line spacing options. So you have to prepare this one. Control 1 is the shortcut for single line spacing. Control plus 5, that means together you have to press control plus 1, control plus 5. From the keyboard you have to use two fingers and then press it together to make these changes. But children, remember that before making the change you have to first select. If you want to increase the line spacing between the lines of a particular paragraph or in the whole document, if you want to apply this change, then you first select it. Whichever portion in which you want to see the change, select it with the help of the mouse, drag it and select, and then you apply these changes. You can apply or you can make these changes by using the shortcuts or by clicking on the various options that appear on the ribbon. Control plus 5 is 1.5 spacing. Control plus 2 is for double spacing, etc. Then page 41. To adjust spacing with more precision, select line spacing options menu to access the paragraph dialog box. If we want to make other kinds of adjustment, whatever option is provided to us, if we are not satisfied with those options like single, 1.5, double, at least, exactly, if we are not satisfied, then we can do it of our own. And these are the options which I told you, it appears like this. Whichever you choose, it will be applied. And you have to finally click this OK to make these changes. Then you have the paragraph spacing option. Again, paragraph spacing means, in line spacing what I told you, in between the lines the space will be increased or decreased, that is adjusted. Paragraph spacing means between the two or three or four paragraphs which are there in the Word document, between the paragraphs the space will be increased or decreased. So paragraph settings or spacing is the amount of white space, that means blank space between paragraphs. It can be measured in lines or points. How to do that? What are the steps? You place the cursor anywhere in the paragraph. Then under home tab, You will get under click line and paragraph spacing command. Hold the mouse over the add space before paragraph or remove space before paragraph. You see below here, add space, remove space option you will get. From there, whatever you choose, the changes you will be able to see. But again, I repeat, children, when you want to make these changes, first select your paragraph, then you apply these changes. Otherwise, it will not be done. Next, the paragraph spacing will change in the document. Another way to change is that from that drop down menu, you can select line spacing options. This line spacing options you can select and then control how much space you want to put after and before the paragraph, and then it will be done. Then is copy formatting. Format Painter is a tool in Word which is used to copy the formatting to a portion of a text to another portion. Particular change I want to copy from one to the other position, we can do that. Select the text. See, they have selected this text, therefore this color has come here. On the Home tab, this is the Home tab. This is the Home tab. In the clipboard group, click on the Format Painter option. Here you will find the Format Painter option. Pointer will change to a paintbrush. When you choose Format Painter option, from the pointer an arrow comes. Now that arrow will change to a paintbrush icon. Bring the cursor to the text that you want to format and click on the text. To stop formatting, press the ESC. From the keyboard, you can press ESC button to stop it. This is how you have to do. Next, on page 83, see, creating lists, number 1, 2, 3 or some bullets like dots or points or ticks we can put to make list, to prepare some list. Bullets or numbers make a list look very attractive. Say for example, your mother wants to send you to the market and she has made a list of the items that she wants you to bring. So she may put some number beside and make a list so that it is very clear, look very attractive and nice. So that is a list. A bulleted list means there will be some dot, circle or any other like this. And a number list means in Roman or in normal numeric, you will find some numbers. Again, you have to type the items first. Then from the Home tab, you have to click the drop down arrow here. Drop down arrow and then choose any bullets and then select a bullet style, and finally if you click, that particular style will be applied. So these are the bullet styles. See, arrow, dot, some star, some circle like this. Then you have creating numbered list, same way. See, there are numbers here, any numbers of your choice in the same process, in that same